Hi everybody, so welcome back to our video number 4 about the characteristics of oral English. Today we're going to go to the fourth tip, that's to say, the tone. What is tone first if we have to describe it? So it's very difficult to define, in fact, because it gathers many, many things. In fact, well, we have the tone, you know, the tone of your voice when you're speaking, but it also corresponds to the pacing, that's to say the rhythm you're going to use while speaking, to the volume of your voice, okay, whether you are shouting like that or you are whispering things like this. It corresponds as well to the emphasis you're going to lay, that was step two that we saw together already. To the different pauses you're going to have during your speech, and to conclude, it gathers as well the notion of intonation that we're going to say in tip 5. Plus, just to add to all this, it also includes non-verbal elements. Say things which are not said, but that you can see. For example, when you are speaking to a person, I mean, this person sees your face, and what you're going to say is going to change according to whether you're going to roll your eyes, for example, you're going to pull a face at the same time you speak, or your body language as well is going to be very important if you're putting your hands up or if you're hugging the person at the same time, for example, to compliment him or her. That's quite important. So, in fact, tone is really, the notion of tone is difficult to comprehend in itself, but it gives elements to your listener about how he should understand your message, okay? It doesn't really correspond to the words you say. Well, of course it doesn't, obviously, but it's not the message in itself, it's the way you're going to deliver your message to the person. Just an example, if I'm saying, great, okay, you're going to understand, well, obviously it's this person here, okay? Well, my teacher is really pleased and she's really happy about this. But if I'm saying, for example, great, okay, rolling my eyes like this, okay, it's not a compliment, okay? I'm not really happy about this and I being really ironic, in fact. So the first activity I'd like you to do about this is to listen to Kim. She's going to repeat the word really many, many times. All right, so you can put the subtitles on to help you, and you can slow down the speed. All right, so she's going to repeat these words in using many different tones. She will be also using some elements we're going to say in tip 5 for intonation. So I'd like you to listen to her very carefully. All right, try to repeat as well the different ways she's using the word really, I mean different ways she's saying the word really. And the second activity is for you to watch the video Play Phrase Me. You're going to listen to this expression, thank you for that, said in many different ways. All right, what I want you to do is to watch this video, whose link you can find here and in description as well. So I'd like you to listen to this video and to pause, you know, after each thank you for that, which is said. And I'd like you to repeat the way it is said, okay, by trying to use the same tone, all right? Okay, so try to do these two activities and we'll see you for our next video next time. Bye-bye, everyone.